Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Amen. You are very welcome here today as we come together for the funeral mass at Tom Cronin, a much loved and highly respected member of this community. I welcome those who are in the church today. I welcome also all those who are joining us through Facebook. We come today to celebrate Tom's life, to thank God for his life, and to bid him a fond farewell. We come to offer the Mass, the greatest prayer we have, for the happy repose of his soul. And we come here to the church, and I know those who are joining us on Facebook, those who put up condolences, those who are along the road as you come and go from the church to the graveyard, we all have come in order to offer our sincere sympathy, our prayers and our support to Tom's family and his friends, and to all those who mourn his passing. As we begin our Mass, we call to mind the Lord's love and mercy, and we place before him any time we failed him or any time we failed one another. You raised the dead to life in the Spirit, Lord, have mercy. You give pardon and peace to the sinner, Christ, have mercy. You give light to those in darkness, Lord, have mercy. And the Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. And let us pray. O God, Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, your servant Tom Cronin, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. And we sit now as we listen to the word of God. St. John. Think of the love that the Father has lavished on us by letting us be called God's children, and that is what we are. Because the world refused to acknowledge him, therefore it does not acknowledge us. My dear people, we are already children of God. What we are to be in the future has not yet been revealed. All we know is that when it is revealed, we should be like him, because we should see him as he really is. The Word of the Lord.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is none.
Jesus from Nazareth had been in the tomb for 4 days already. Bethany is only about 2 miles from Jerusalem, and many Jews had come to Martha and Mary to sympathize with them over their brother. When Martha heard that Jesus had come, she went to meet him. Mary remained sitting in the house. Martha said to Jesus, "If you had been here, my brother would not have died. But I know that even now, whatever you ask of God, he will grant you." "Your brother," said Jesus to her, "will rise again." Martha said, "I know he will rise again at the resurrection on the last day." Jesus said, "I am the resurrection and the life. If anyone believes in me, even though he dies, he will live. And whoever lives and believes in me will never die. Do you believe this?" "Yes, Lord," she said, "I believe that you are Christ, the Son of God, the one who was to come into this world." The Gospel of the Lord. Listen just for a moment. "I am the resurrection and the life. If anyone believes in me, even though he dies, he will live. And whoever lives and believes in me, will never die." Words spoken by Jesus to Martha in the Gospel which I have just read. And these words form the faith of the Church, and they are very much the faith of Tommy Cronin in whose funeral mass we take part today. Tommy believed in Jesus as his Lord and Saviour. And today, as we are gathered, it's our prayer and our faith for Tommy that he who lived and believed in Christ, now that he has died in this world, will live forever in the happiness and in the joy of God's eternal home. That's our faith for Tommy today, and our faith for each and every one of us in our time. Even though our faith in the resurrection is strong, death is a parting, and parting with a loved one is always difficult. It leaves an emptiness, a void in our lives, a space that cannot be filled. So today, on behalf of all those who miss Tommy, who love Tommy, on behalf of all those who are listening on Facebook, those who are here in the church, for all the people in the parish, I offer sincere sympathy to Tommy's family and friends. To those who can be here and those who can't be here, we offer our sympathy and our support today. We offer our sympathy to Tommy's wife Carmel, to his brothers John, Dennis and Michael, to his sisters Greta, Patricia and Bina, to his nephews and nieces, his relatives, his neighbours, and his many friends. Today I offer your sincere sympathy and our prayers and our support. And my own prayer today is that your own faith in the resurrection and support and help you with those around you, albeit in different ways now, that at all will help you through this difficult time. Tommy, as I said, was a man of faith, his prayers, his mass, was an important part of his life. And we now pray that God, whom he met through prayer, whom he met in the sacraments, that he may now meet him and be with him face to face in the joys of heaven. Tommy, I think everyone has said that I've met in the last few days, and indeed I would have normally said before that, Tommy was a gentleman. A friendly, kind, pleasant man, a good neighbour, and a friend to all. And today we thank God for that. Tommy worked in the land, he was a farmer, a good farmer, and the pastime he loved was both more than anything else was the game of cards. A number of nights a week, maybe most nights, some weeks, he'd be out in different locations, different places, meeting up with his friends for a game of cards. It was the pastime that he enjoyed. But in recent years he met some ill health, but he wasn't the kind of man to complain, he kept going to the best of his ability. He was always pleasant, always had a smile. Today, as we pray for him, we thank God for his life, for the goodness of his life, for his love of God and love of neighbour. And St. Paul said that the life and death of each of us has an influence on others. If we live, we live for the Lord, and if we die for the Lord. So today, we thank God for Tommy's life, and for the good influence he was on others, and the good example he gave to others. We thank God for that today. And today, as we remember him, as we pray for him, as we thank God for him, we pray for ourselves. We pray that we too may give lives of love of God and love of neighbour, and that we too may come one day to share in the happiness and joy, and share with Tommy and all those who come before us in the happiness of God's eternal home. That's our prayer for Tommy today and for each of us in our work. And now we stand for the prayers of the faithful. God, the Almighty Father, raised Christ, his Son, from the dead. With confidence, we ask him to save all his people, living and dead. We pray for Tommy, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life. May he now be admitted to the company of the saints. Lord, hear us. We pray for our brother Tom, who ate the body of Christ, the bread of life, that he may be raised up on the last day. Lord, hear us. We pray for our deceased relatives and friends, and for all those who have gone before us, those who have helped us, that they may all be rewarded for their goodness. Lord, hear us. For those who have fallen asleep in the hope of rising again, that they may see the Lord face to face. Lord, hear us. For the family and friends of Tom Cronin, that they may be consoled in their grief by the Lord who wept at the death of his friend Lazarus. Lord, hear us. For all of us attempted here to worship in faith, that we may be gathered together again in God's kingdom. Lord, hear us. We pray for all those who are sick at this time. We pray too for all those who care for the sick. We ask the Lord to touch the sick with your healing love and restore them to their health. We ask you to bless and protect those who care for the sick and reward them for their goodness. Lord, hear us. We pray in silence for a moment for eternal rest for Tom's soul. We pray that he may have eternal rest. And we share the joy of God's kingdom. And for all our other intentions and for all those who ask for our prayers, we pray now for a moment in silence. God, our shelter and our strength, you listen in love to the cry of your people. Hear the prayers we offer for our departed brothers and sisters. Cleanse them of their sins and grant them the fullness of redemption. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. You may sit down for the offertory, and in the offertory we offer the bread and wine, which will become at this Mass the body and blood of Christ. As we offer all we have and all we do, and all the efforts and all the time we did, we offer his life back to the Lord today. We ask him to bless Tommy's efforts and to bless the efforts that each of us made to give good lives as we go through this new year and each day of that year.
Just one thing that counts. Did I do my best to live for you?
extend now in praise to those brothers and our sacrifice, may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Tom Cronin, we beseech your mercy, that he who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Saviour may find him a merciful Judge, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. Lift up your hearts, we lift them up to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and just. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that though saddened by the certainty of dying, might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with the angels and the archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Let us proclaim in song the mystery of our faith.
He is Lord, he is Lord, he is risen from the dead and he is Lord. Every knee shall bow, every tongue confess that Jesus Christ.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring it to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, William our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant Tommy Cronin, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who is united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, in Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. This day now, and at the Saviour's command and form by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and saved from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. We just pray for peace for a moment for each other, for ourselves, peace for those who are near us, and peace for those who fell away. Pray for peace, especially for anyone going through any difficulty this time, for those who are mourning, for all who are mourning. We ask the Lord to give them peace. We pray especially for eternal peace and light and joy and rest for Tommy Cronin and for all who did. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy to enter into my room, but only say the word of my soul to you. May the body of Christ bring us to everlasting life. Who join us now on the live stream, I invite you to join in an act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things and desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you if you are already there and unite myself wholly to you. Therefore, permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Here, just come around the table and come here to receive. And give yourselves plenty of room, each group, maybe stay, you know, 2 meters apart.
that village on the hill. The day I left my native home, I had felt sad and sore. I had to seek employment here on this foreign shore. Although I made a fortune here, I will not rest until return again to being that village on the hill. Now I have spent a lifetime in this foreign country. Although it's rich and prosperous, it's still not home for me. But someday soon I'm going back, and if it is God's will, then I'll end my days in meaning that village on the hill. Then I'll end my days in meaning that village on the hill. Protect you, trouble neglect you, heaven expects you, it's time to go home. You always have plenty, your glass never empty, and no penny or belly, you're never alone. May your tears come from laughing, find friends worth having, with every year passing, they're worth more than gold. May you win and stay humble, smile more than grumble, know when you stumble, never alone. Never alone, never alone. I'll be in every beat of your heart when you face the unknown. Whenever you fly, this isn't goodbye. My love will follow you, stay with you, baby, you're never alone. Well, I have to be honest, as much that I wanted, I'm not going to promise that the cold winds won't blow. So when hard times have found you, and your fears surround you, wrap my love round you, you're never alone. Never alone, never alone. I'll be in every beat of your heart when you face the unknown. Whenever you fly, this isn't goodbye.
sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. Let perpetual life shine upon them with your saints forever, for you are merciful. Eternal rest grant upon them, O Lord, and let perpetual life shine upon them with your saints forever, for you are merciful. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. O Jesus, we love you, help us to love you daily more and more. Help us to show our love for you in the way we treat other people. Make us kind and generous to all. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. And let us stand and pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body and blood, food for the journey. Merciful Father, grant it strengthened by it, our brother Tommy Cronin may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother Tom. May our farewell express our affection for him, may it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. We pray now for a moment in silence for the repose of Tom's soul, and we bless the coffin with holy water, reminding us of our baptism, of Tom's baptism when he became a child of God. And we also use incense, symbolizing Tom's body, all our bodies are temples of the Holy Spirit. And as the incense rises, may it symbolize Tom's soul rising to the Lord, accompanied today by our prayers. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Saints of God, come to his aid. Hasten to meet him, angels of the Lord. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May the angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our brother Tom Cronin. In the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Tommy in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and have our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn towards us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with the assurances of faith, until we all meet in Christ, and we are with you and with our brother forever. Amen. In peace, let us take our brother to his place of rest.
Reverend, let us pray to God, the source of all blessings. You raised the dead to life. Give our brother Conforming eternal life. Lord, to mercy. You consoled Martha and Mary in their distress. Draw near to us, O Morden, for Thomas, and dry the tears of those who weep. Lord, to mercy. Comfort us in our sorrow as the death of Tommy. Let our faith be our consolation and eternal life our hope. Lord, to mercy. We pray for all those who are buried in the cemetery. May their suffering be lessened. May their joy be increased. May the light of glory shine on them, and may they rest in peace. Lord, have mercy.
Amen.
With longing for the coming of God's kingdom, let us pray together as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. God of holiness and power, accept our prayers on behalf of your servant Tommy. Do not count his deeds against him, for in his heart he desires to do your will. As his faith united him to your people on earth, so may your mercy join him to the angels in heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Merciful Lord, you know the anguish of the sorrowful. You are attentive to the prayers of the humble. Hear your people who cry out to you in their need, and strengthen their hope in your lasting goodness. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
And we pray in the Rosary now for the happy repose of his soul, reflecting on the first glorious mystery, the resurrection of Jesus from the dead, and praying that Tommy and all our dead will share to the full in that resurrection. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our
trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb,
Jesus.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. May the prayers of Mary, the Mother of God, who stood by the cross as her son was dying, help those who mourn for Tom, and accompany all of us in our time of need. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord. May he rest in peace. May his soul and the souls of all the faithful departed, the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
It's funny how time goes so when you're younger, and you think it's forever till you reach 21. But time don't stand still, and time waits for no man. In the blink of an eye, sure time marches on. Don't ponder too long what if or what maybe. The past is the past, and time we can't change. But if given a chance, sure we'd all do things different.
and the words that we spoke, we can't rearrange. But it's nice that we all are here together and spending the time, the company of friends. I had a friend, and once he did tell me that when he goes out, he enjoys every night, in case it's his last, he enjoys every moment. He's bound to be right. What good is wealth or fame or fortune? And what's it all for at the end of the day? We're only just passing through, and you can't take it with. I'd rather my friends that I meet round the way. But it's nice that we all are here together and spending the time, the company of friends. Nobody God sends. So let's make the most of the time that God sends.